Oh my goodness. I forgot to hit mute. Sorry about that. Hi everyone. Welcome to Heather's Art Adventures. I hope you're ready to have some fun. Hello and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. I have something I need to take care of. I owe Mr. Michael Daniels something. So there it is. There it is for Mr. Michael Daniels. Thank you for your fabulous and wonderful gifts the day before. And then yesterday, even though I wasn't live, Michael Daniels comes on here thinking we're live and leaves more bits. So I put together this little crazy look at some past. Do you guys remember I used to take my picture afterwards? Well, T-Dog would take my picture after every episode of Craft It Live, and this would be part of the thumbnail or whatever, we'd send it out. Sometimes I made some funky faces. Not on purpose, just the way it worked. I make funky faces like regularly. So, all right, that's the end of that. We're still jelly plating for the time being, but let's see. Hello to everyone who's here. Jules, Andrew. Oh, look, the little one is out there. Hi, sweetheart. Take care of your Grammy. Jazz, thanks for being here. Let's see, we got Melissa here. Thank you guys. I can't believe I sneezed that, but I'm trying really hard to not sneeze again. I don't know if you can tell. Question: are eardrums in any of your kits? Nope, sorry. I really am sorry. Did not mean to do that to you guys. Oh, it's terrible. If you weren't here before, you missed me sneezing in your ears. Sorry about that, really. I'm trying really hard to finish this little thing here. All right, 1 second. Almost done. Almost. All right. Okay, I think I got it now. All right, I think I need to actually mute and blow my nose because if I don't, I'm going to sound like this and almost sneeze all the rest of the day. So hang on 1 second. All right, that's better. Wonderful. Okay, so here's the deal. I'm getting bored with this jelly plating thing. And, you know, it has nothing to do with the jelly plate. It has nothing to do with the challenges. I just can't really do anything for an entire month like this. Even in the past, when I was doing Craft It Live, doing, you know, an entire piece for the whole month, like in December, I would always do something Christmas related. Or even a couple weeks leading up to, you know, that's how I did it in the past. But it was like once a week. So I had a bunch of other things during the week in between that I would be wrapping my head around. So it wasn't like I was just focusing on that one thing. Well, this has been every day that we've been together. This is what I'm doing. And lately, and this has been part of my problem and part of the reason why I wasn't on yesterday, part because there's lots of reasons, none of which I really want to go into publicly. But anyway, so part of the reason I wasn't on yesterday is because I have not had any time to do the mundane life stuff in between. So realistically, the only art that I get anymore these days is when we hang out together. And that's not normal for me. And I like that we can have this conversation while I'm busy cleaning my plate with my alcohol. What is this stuff called? Hand sanitizer and my fingers. Just getting everything all cleaned off of there. And the reason I'm doing that is because it's been a couple days since I used it, and I left some paint on there that was getting sticky and keeping the paint on there as well. So I appreciate your patience as I do this. So one of the things when I started this whole Twitch, I'm moving over to Twitch. I'm not going to do live streaming on YouTube anymore. One of the reasons was because for almost 6 years, or for actually 6 years, it was 6 years, I did a show called Craft It Live on YouTube. And I looked at it as almost like a television show where I had to be prepared. I had to have an idea of what I was going to be working on. Sometimes I would do a lot of research to make sure I had the right tools, the right terminology. You know, there was a lot that went into that show. Not every show, but for the most part, I did prepare. I did my best to make it an hour long, sometimes a little over, show. Literally a show, an episode, a something that had a beginning, a middle, and an end. On occasion, we would stretch that out over a couple of episodes, but for the most part, it was an hour-long episode that you could enjoy, and you would get a wrapped-up, completed project. Well, those days are... They're over for me. Like, I really don't function well under those circumstances anymore. I can very quickly put stuff together. There's no doubt about that. I've trained for years, like Olympic training, on how to put art together in an hour. But that art does not make me as happy as the things that take me longer. So what I'm working on now, or wanting to ultimately be able to do with you guys, is to basically sit in my art studio as if I were doing the long, tedious projects that I love to do, and you guys are just sort of here to listen, here to interact with, here to keep me going, even give ideas, even chat about some of the tough stuff. And there's been some tough stuff in my world lately. And I know for several of you watching right now, there's been some tough stuff for you too. And so I think it's fair to say we can hang out and we can chat. But this 30 days of gel printing has not been that for me. And honestly, printing all of these papers, so much fun to do in the moment, but does not give me that intense satisfaction of a completed project and the build up towards that completed project. Until the other day, and I'm going to show you these. You may have already seen this if you follow me on other social media avenues. But the other day, I took some time to take those. If you remember, we used these cards, these pieces of cardstock to create these blocks of color. And then I took, afterwards, I took my black pen and my white pen, and I created or embellished, I should say, embellished this page to create an art piece. And when I was all done, it just, there's no other word that explains how I felt. I felt full of hope when it was over with. I felt like, you know what, this is what I want to do. Like, I would have loved to have sat with the camera on and just doodled. And if anyone was watching, fine. And if they weren't, fine as well. And I had a great time and it was so much fun. I not only did that, I also did I turned these into cards. This was the last one that I did because I wanted to try something new. I'll explain that in a bit. But just went in with a stencil and put the little dots in the background of this. That got me going. And then I created with another stencil this one. Like I said, you may have already seen these because I did show a video demonstrating these, but I put together some new stamps that I got from that wonderful weekend that I spent with Sylvia, and I put these together. These are from three different stamp sets, I think, maybe two, and just stamped those. This was a stamp set, and you can probably tell that it's smeared because I didn't set it with, this was set with embossing powder. But anyway, my point is that then I put them onto cardstock and turned them into cards. And I was very happy about that. Let me explain this for a second. You guys may be familiar with gilding flakes. You get like a jar of these flakes that have multicolors in them. And then you put down something sticky, and you put those flakes on top. You have to kind of rub it off with a sponge. After you burnish it in, rub it off with a sponge, and then this is what you're left with. And it's almost like burnt copper, like when you put heat to copper, and you can't really see all of the coloring, but there's turquoise and orange and red, and it's just so pretty. But anyway, I had to try that, and that seemed like a good one to do it on. And I love the results, so we're going to be playing with that more. But what happened was when I finished this, I got the idea to put a mat around it, and this is where I started to realize this is what's missing in my life. Like, I need to get to the point where I'm making pieces that fill me with the joy and the hope that was left when I was done with this. That's what I need to be working on, I should say. Hey, we got Mert in the house. So glad you're here. Yay. Thank you very much for that. Love ya. Love ya. All right. And Andrew says, I understand completely. I mean, how many times can you roll a bit of paint on a jelly plate? And that's kind of how I'm feeling this morning. It's really how I'm feeling this morning. But we're going to stick with it till tomorrow. Tomorrow will be our last day of jelly plating. I didn't want to just quit. I know that I unexpectedly canceled yesterday's live stream. And like I said, when we started this whole process, it's going to happen sometimes. I just can't fix that. So as long as you guys are patient with me and understanding, that's really important. All of that to say, today's prompt is complementary colors. And so I wanted to kind of use the jelly plate to teach color wheel, color theory. I don't know. That sounds too bold. So let's just do this. Okay. I'm going to take these three colors. These are not primary colors, but they're close. Okay. I like mixing these because two reasons. Number one, I already know how they're going to react. So I use these all the time and I love how they interact with each other and they're going to give the results that I want you guys to see. Number two, they are pretty close to primary colors in the sense that we have a red, a yellow, and a blue, okay? Technically speaking, this blue is actually teal, but if you were to go with the cyan, magenta, yellow, this is pretty close to cyan. Not quite, but it's pretty close. So that'll work. And because they're the same company and same product, meaning high flow acrylic ink or acrylic paint, sorry, they're going to work really well together. If we had used, like, say, I replaced this one with this, although they will work, they won't work really well together because this is a different viscosity, it's a different company, it's been mixed differently, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, so let's just go with this and we're gonna have some fun. All right. Let's see. Mert says, I've actually never seen gel printing or gel plating. Well, stay tuned, sweetheart. This is all for you. Life does happen. That's very true. And thank you, Jane. I appreciate that. All right. So let's talk about colors. So we got the three primary colors, okay? And I'm just giving them a mixture because they are high flow, which means they have a high liquid viscosity. As you can see, they're just like ink almost. And then they do have like a ball bearing inside there that helps mix the paint with the liquid medium that makes them liquidy. Okay, and we're just going to go ahead and roll this one out. This is yellow. Okay, we're just going to roll this out onto our plate and give us a base color. So we'll just pull that off. And now we have a yellow base layer, okay? And I did a real thin layer because I didn't want to do multiple prints. So the next one is magenta. This would be our red, okay? Real thin layer. Might be too thin, might need more. Maybe not because I've got, yeah, we need more. There's no doubt we need more. Okay, so now we're going to just roll this out, give ourselves a good layer of that. Okay, and we're going to pull out another piece of paper to give us a red base layer. Or in this case, it's magenta. So we'll just go with magenta base layer. Whoop, that was an extra piece of paper just slid right off there. All right. So now we have our red, we have our yellow. We're basically making a little bit of a color wheel, so to speak, okay? So now let's do the teal. Now you're gonna notice something that's a little bit different, and if I put these together, you'll see yellow and magenta both have a transparency to them. You can see those black lines through the color sample that they put on the front of the bottle. When we look at this one, no black lines. Okay, so that means that this one will not be transparent. We're going to zoom in a little bit. I didn't realize I was out that far. Okay. And what is Mertz asking? Is that hot press watercolor paper? No, ma'am. It is just a cardstock. Simple. Even I buy like a ream of this at the copy store, you know, Office Max, etc. Just a ream of heavier than copy paper cardstock. Okay, there's our teal. Now, I just talked about it being not transparent. Oops, mixing a little bit of magenta in there by accident. It is not transparent. However, when we roll it out thin enough, we can make it more transparent than if it were painted on with a brush. So that's going to help us on this plate. So if I were painting with it, it would definitely have less transparency than the other two paints. You know, if I was using a brush and doing that, translucent, exactly same word, translucent, transparent. They're really the same word. No texture then, not at all. No, ma'am. No texture, smooth as pie. You can use watercolor paper on your gel print or gel plate. It's totally fine. We're just not doing that today. So today's all about color. That's what we're going to focus on. So you can see there's a little bit of magenta one, and it's okay. We got our yellow, we got our magenta, and our blue, okay? So now if you also notice something about this, these are the three colors that make up your printer cartridge as well. So these three colors, with these three colors, you can pretty much paint the world, okay? It is possible. And because these are golden paints, they mix really well, and they're mostly pigment with high quality. It's high quality pigment with high quality mediums. So when you mix these, you're going to end up more true than if you were to, say, use a 98-cent craft store, you know, craft store brand paint. Not that there's anything wrong with those. We're just talking about true to color mixtures, okay? So let's go back to that teal and put just a little bit on there. And then now we're going to talk about what happens when you mix these colors. So we've got this beautiful teal that we're spreading out on our gelatin plate, which mine happens to be a Jelly Arts gelatin plate, but there's a couple of different companies out there. And some are better than others, and some are exactly the same, so it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to pick up a stamp. This is just going to remove some of that paint from spots. And I just twisted it for some reason. I don't know what I was doing. I'm just going to remove some of that paint. So we're just removing some of it here and there. Just going to leave us with some spots. So let's go ahead and take half of our yellow and put that on, and half of our magenta and put that on. And we'll just push those on there, and hopefully it didn't dry too fast on us because I was kind of slow. And we're just going to pull off. And we're going to pull off. And here we get to see how those two colors interact. And because of the layering, you can kind of see that this has turned into a green and this has turned into a purple. Okay, so that's giving us like a version of mixture, right? So now let's go with yellow. And make sure I clean off my brayer. And because of the transparency, we're able to layer these colors together. And there I've got some blue because I mixed it. Just makes it kind of fun. All right. So now we're going to take this teal, and we'll put that on half of this one. And then we'll go with this one and not do half. We're going to do part of. So we can still see our magenta on the other portion. Okay. So now we've got all three colors on one paper, plus an orangish and a purplish. And now we have green. You can see how layering one on top of the other versus the other makes it a little bit better green. All right. Also matters how wet it is too. That does matter. Let's get one more piece just to clean this section up here. So now this is not like, you know, true color mixture. We're just showing how we get the different colors, okay? I hope you're following me. All right, so now the third color, magenta. Give that a good mixture. Roll it out on our plate. All All right, we're going to do a part of this one. This is the teal. We're going to do a part of the teal. So we're left with three color blocks. Just like that. We'll do a part of the yellow. Just like that. Okay. And I'm just going to clean this up with the rest of this. Now, if we were to mix all three of these colors on the plate at the same time, we would essentially end up with a muddy brown color, like you'll see here, because there's some blue in that yellow, some magenta over the top of it, and you get this sort of muddy brown color. And the more you mix it, the more muddy brown it gets, okay? Now, with our makeshift color wheel, we can kind of see you've got like a variation. Like this is a good one. This is a good one here. If this one had just plain yellow, like you can see the yellow right here, right? You can see that yellow. You see the green. You see the blue. You see the magenta. And you see the purple. This is a good example of that. What you don't see on this one is the orange, where the yellow and the magenta have come together and overlapped. You don't see that. So that's right here. That's that orange color, right? So that's how you get those rainbow colors, okay? Mixing those three colors. Now, when we do a color wheel, which I thought I grabbed mine, but I can't seem to see it. So rather than make you wait for me to find it, we're going to talk about the color wheel like this, okay? So red, orange, yellow, blue, purple. Okay, are you following? So it's red, orange, yellow, green. Sorry, I mixed that one. Blue and purple. Okay? And this purple doesn't look as good as this purple over here does, but you get the idea. So red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, or purple. Okay, you following? I think you're following. All right, so if this was a wheel, right, then we have orange and blue are like on the opposite sides of the wheel. So when they talk about complementary colors, we're talking about things that are the opposite on a wheel. So let's do it like this, because I don't have, let's do it like this. Let's mix on our plates. We're just going to go ahead in with the, I'm going to start with the magenta because that's what was on my brayer. So we're going to start with magenta and we're going to just put it in this section up here. Okay. And I'm going to work quickly so we don't get drying time affecting us too poorly. And clean off my brayer real good because this is, I don't want to mix them. I want to mix them, but I don't want to mix them right there. That did not work too great. A little bit more yellow to get more of a true yellow here. Let's see if I can't clean off my brayer better. I should have started with yellow because it's a lighter color. Or get a different brayer. That would work too, Heather. You could use a different brayer. And then the teal. And we're kind of making a color wheel ourselves here. Okay. So this is our teal. So we got our magenta, which I think I need to put a little bit more on, and I'm going to grab a different brayer. I really am. Come on. Work with me, people. Where'd my brayer go? Ah, here, we'll just use this one. Okay. All right, so there's the magenta, the yellow, and the teal, okay? Now, let's see if we can't mix a little bit on this end over here so that we get our yellow and our magenta mixture up in there. And then we'll do the same thing down here with the yellow and the teal. And then the magenta and the teal. Not so easy to do, but we're doing it. All right, so now if we pull this, we should have a wheel. And hopefully those colors have mixed good enough that we can see them. Like I said in the beginning, this is not exact science with these three colors, but hopefully it'll help you understand the color wheel and what it is that we're trying to accomplish here today. That's a pretty print. Okay, so now you can see a wheel, and you can see that the magenta, the blue, and the yellow make up these three points, and then the orange, the purple, and the green are these three points, right? So if I were to take a marker, and we will just make a circle here. Okay, so there's magenta, teal, and yellow, or red, blue, yellow, yeah? And then here we have our purple, our green, and our orange, and you'll notice those are smaller circles. So I know it's not a perfect circle, but you get the idea, because these are secondary colors. So we got primary, those three, the bigger ones are primary, and the three smaller are secondary. And then of course you have multiple colors in between where it's a little bit more yellow than blue or a little bit more blue than yellow. You get the idea. But the point that we're making today is three colors primary to create three colors secondary, and then to talk about the opposite of the color wheel. So we have red and green are opposite of each other. If I were to draw a line across our circle, our color wheel here, we would have red and green are opposite. That's why they go so well together for Christmas time, because they are complementary. They complement each other. Okay. We have blue and orange across the wheel from each other because, again, blue and orange are complementary colors. And then purple and yellow, opposite of each other. So if we were to do today's prompt for the 30 days of gel printing and say, we're going to work with complementary colors, we now know that if we use yellow, the complement is purple, and vice versa. If we use purple, the complement is yellow, right? So are we understanding? I may not know gel prints, but at least know the color wheel. Well, that's awesome, because not everybody understands that. And so a lot of people will ask, I love the gel print looks that I see, but I can't do them because I always end up with mud. And this is a big reason why you end up with mud, is because you don't understand the color wheel. So as I said, at one point, when we, here it is, mix all of the primary colors, we get a muddy mess. The same is true when we're mixing the opposite colors, because if you think about it, it's two colors here plus the one primary, right? This is two primary colors mixed with one primary color. So all of them will end up with brown. So if you were to mix yellow and purple, you end up with an ugly mess. And that makes today's prompt a little bit more challenging, which is why I started with our color wheel. Because if I just go, all right, they want us to use complementary colors, which are yellow and purple in this case, for example, and then you mix them on the plate, you end up with a terrible, ugly mess. So we don't want that. So what we're going to do is start with one color. And hope my brayer is clean enough to make this work without it being an ugly mess. All right. So we're going to start with our one color, which is yellow. And I think I'm going to put down just a little bit more yellow. Okay, that maybe a lot more yellow then. That's also an option. Okay, so there's a lot more yellow as opposed to the little bit I was going to put out there. And we will just take a background print of that. Okay, so we have a nice yellow color base, and it's going to have a little bit of the other prints that we put down. A little smidgen of teal is in there, a little smidgen of magenta is in there, and that's okay because that's just going to give us a nice interest to our background. Okay, so this is a great background pull. Look at that. Perfect coloring. That's awesome. All right, so we'll set that one aside. Now, and I had a couple weeks ago, maybe last week, I have no idea, it's all seemed to run together. I have these natural bits that I pulled out of the yard, and this tree leaf thing fell off the tree, and now it's starting to turn sitting here. That's kind of neat, but it's got all this texture in it. So I kind of thought this would be fun to use in this particular painting today. Okay, so this is over here. I'm letting it dry. That's why I'm stalling. And now we're going to go ahead and mix ourselves a purple. And we know from our little color wheel class, we're just going to mix that up, that we go a little bit of magenta and a little bit of teal. And we make the most glorious color ever invented on the planet, this beautiful purple. I don't think you can get this purple anywhere else. I love this color. And if you've been around here for maybe 15 minutes, you've probably seen me use this color a few times. Okay, so we're just going to lay our, I should have just done half of the plate, to be honest with you, but that's fine. We don't care. We're going to just lay our bits in here to get us a little bit of texture in the background. And just because we can, I'm going to put these doilies over here. Here's another doily. Let's just do it up here, off the edge there. All right, so now you've seen me do this a bunch of times as well. If you've been watching, just going to get some deli paper. I'm trying to work quickly. It's not really being successful. All right, here we go. So some deli paper. This is just like what they wrap sandwiches in at the deli, hence deli paper. I know in not every country is it available, but it definitely is on Amazon. I know many people have told me they buy it on Amazon. You could buy waxed paper. This is waxed on one side, but then dry on the other. So a dry wax is what you're looking for. Also, just make sure I get all this paint around here. Also, a good thing to use is really thin, cheapy copy paper. That also works well. Not as perfectly, but well. Okay, so now we got these marks left on our plate. And quickly, before they dry, we're going to go ahead and add that pull to our yellow background. And now we are working complementary colors on one pull and not making mud, which is very exciting to me. I like this right here. So let's go ahead and pull that up and see, were we successful? Did it work? And ta-da. That is a beautiful print. Now, what you could do with this, as you saw in my earlier discussion when we first started all of this, is to pull out pens and doodle or leave it as is. I mean, when you put a mat around something, I don't know, it's like magic. Watch this. Bam, artwork, instant artwork, hang it on the wall. So do you see how you can make things to just decorate your area, like whatever color scheme you have? You can make these very unique pieces that will never, nobody else will have. nobody else will have. So let's just keep on with that contrast color scheme. So let's see, blue, we'll make a teal background. We're going to make a teal background. And notice there's still some print stuff left on there. We're going to see how that goes with this. Let's just roll it out with this one here. Teal background. Just going to pull this as best we can. Maybe a little bit more on the plate. So I want a really good background print. Here we go. Get as solid as I can. Pull off a really good background print. Yeah, Mert saying wow to that complimentary print. And I don't blame you because it's pretty cool. All right, let's do another one though. So this one is going to be, we started with blue. So what's going to be our complementary color that we need to mix in order for it to work? What do we need to put on this? So there's our background. Love the texture left on it by the beading of the plate. It almost looks like stars in the sky a little bit. I like it. All right, so we're going to set that one aside to dry. What's the color mixture that we need to have? Anybody know? Anybody have any idea? I want to do the same. I don't think I'm going to be able to use that right away. It's still very wet. It's not drying on that. Maybe wonder if I use my heat tool. Because I would like to make the same print in all three sets of complementary colors and see what we get. That's what I want to do. We'll see how it works. All right, so nobody has responded, so I'm just going to give you the answer because I'm a terrible teacher that way. And I've decided, actually, yeah, we'll go with it. Why not? Okay, so the answer is orange. We need to mix orange. So we've got yellow. And we're going to add some magenta. And you might notice that I'm not using as much magenta as yellow. And that is because magenta is the more powerful color in the two. So if I were to just do magenta or an equal amount of the two, it would be much more red than orange. This way, I have some lovely orange color. And we're going to work very quickly. Let's just go right down like this. Okay, that'll go there then. It just fell, so we'll just stick with it. And let's put this piece here and our doily here. And where is deli paper? Right there. Put it down, pull it up. This kind of have to work quickly because it's such a thin layer that I put down that it'll dry. And then we'll be kind of sad because it didn't work and we'll have to do it again. Or we will have ruined our background and have to start completely over. So you get the idea. All right. Just making sure that I pull up what's around here. This is why you like deli paper for this, because you can actually see what you're pulling up and get those crisp details all around this. You can still do it with copy paper, like I said, real thin, cheap copy paper. But it's just a little bit harder to get these crisp line details like this. So now to our blue, goes right on top of there. And hopefully it's still wet enough that it'll pull it off. Another reason to use golden paints for this, although I know that they're more expensive than the 98 cents bottle or even the $2.50 bottle of craft paint, it is totally worth it when making these detailed secondary prints like this, because the paint stays wetter longer. It has more pigment, so you get a much more impressive and more successful print out of that. So there's some contrast or complementary color pulls of blue and orange. And yes, Michael was correct. Thank you, Michael. And thank you, Mert. You got it, guys. All right. So then our next one would be magenta in the background. Right? And the complementary color for red on our color wheel is, I know at some point somebody's going to answer this question, so I'll just let it go. All right, so let's go ahead and pull this one for our next background. That's quite a thin layer. Let's get a thicker layer on there. There, that's going to look a little bit better. Get ourselves a nice print, full color background pull. Okay. And so our complementary color for this one is going to be, did anyone say it? Oh, looks like Jane is already on the board with green. I know that's what she meant to type. She was typing so fast so that I wouldn't give it away before she was heard. All right, green it is. You got it. I'm just going to hit this with the heat tool just because I want to make sure that's nice and dry before we go putting it down on our green paint. Yep, that'll work. And so now we're going to mix green on our plate. I think you guys are getting the idea, are you not? What do you guys think so far? All right, again, because yellow is not the stronger color, it's actually the weaker color out of the primaries. Yellow is, it doesn't take much of the blue or the magenta to mix the color we want, but it does take a little bit more than I gave it. So we are going to add just one or two more drops of that teal and mix it out real well so we have actual green, not teal blobs in here. But you see how simple it is to mix colors, especially if you're using the same type of paint with the same viscosity and so on. And just for composition's sake, I am mixing things up a little, trying to anyway. Let's go here. We'll just put this one up in here and whoop, almost did that backwards. Another deli paper. Pull this paint off. Get those details. You see how I'm holding with one hand and pushing with the other hand around the bits because I don't want the paper to move or the bits underneath because this is not a super flat item. I don't want that leaf pattern to move and ruin our amazing print ability. So I wonder how this one's going to look on here because it's such a faint color. We'll see. Like a darker green might have been more visible, but we'll see. Who knows what will happen? The question is, are you pressing very hard? At this stage right here, I'm giving it pressure. I would say this is like not hard enough for my husband's back rub because he likes a little bit more pressure than I'm giving. But when I'm doing the paper, this stuff, it's not at all really. I'm just literally getting the paint onto the deli paper. That's all I'm doing there. And just like I said, with two hands, because I don't want it to come apart on me See, now this one's interesting because it's very pinkish, and then that green is almost, you can almost not even see it at all because it's just not dark enough on that background. So that's an interesting one. Interesting. All right, so let's go the opposite way. Let's make a green background. So we'll put that blue down and then a green background and a lot more yellow. Maybe this would be a little bit more green than the last one was. The last one was more chartreuse. Anyway, here we go. This would be a nice background. I'm already loving this color. Beautiful. I don't want to take too much of that paint off. Let's just get a whole mess in here. And I don't want you to throw away any that you feel are not, like, you know, great. Like this one didn't turn out great, but we can have some fun with this and even chop it up into die cuts or whatever. We could do whatever we want with this. So it's not garbage. All right. There's a lovely green background with some blue yellow mixture in there. That's fabulous. All right. Now the opposite of that would then be the magenta. So give it a mixture. Slap some of that on there. Well, let's just do enough. We want enough. And then let's go with a different print pole this time and put some more on there first. But I have those fall leaves from the other day. They're just silk flowers or leaves in this case. They will work great for this technique. I'll just put those down. Great textures. And we'll just put this one down here. Okay, and then again, with our deli paper, and I'm going to use the same deli paper from before because it's dry. And then this adds to our layer of deli paper as well. So we're making all of these poles by doing this, and all these papers can be used in so many different ways. And we've kind of been talking a little bit. Whoa, everything falling off of your desk is also an option. That was for you, Andrew. We've talked a little bit about what we would do with our papers. I mean, with 30 days of gel printing, we end up with a huge stack of papers. What would you do with all those papers? Look at that. Beautiful. And the idea was to get some folks to share their ideas. I'm just going to use another piece to make sure we get all of that extra paint off the plate here. And we've had some conversation about it. I was hoping that we'd get some ideas posted in the crafters community over on Discord. Didn't really have too much participation there, and today is your last day to really put anything in there to be considered for the challenge this week and last week. We sort of extended it, but anyway, my point is that I have had some ideas about what I could do because things just keep falling from the sky. Oh, that's hilarious. But some ideas of what you could do. And I think we talked about, obviously, art journal, you know, creating an art journal from it, or collage. And I think we said collage was out of the running because that was sort of obvious, right? Like trimming up these deli papers and whatnot, sort of obvious. So what could we do that's not sort of obvious? Oh, that's amazing. Look at that print. That is so cool. I kind of wish we had like a, I mean, that's lame, but we need an applause button. Wow, I like it. So let's do that same thing with the other ones going backwards. So this is magenta in the background with green on front. Didn't work out so great, but we still got a print. And then this is the opposite of that. Green in the background, magenta on the front. Okay, now let's do this one. We did teal in the background and orange on front. Let's go orange in the background. So I'm going to put down some magenta. Put down some yellow, and I have magenta all over the top of that bottle. That will need to be wiped off or wiped off. That's how it works. And we've got this one here we'll use to mix these guys up. Get a nice orange background. And sometimes you got to pick up your brayer and pull it back and forth, not just roll it back and forth. You got to pick it up. Because if you don't pick it up, your wheel doesn't turn, and then you end up with these striations that don't really mix up. So making the background orange. Oh, I'm running out of full sheets. Uh-oh. All right, we're going to do this one with two smaller sheets then, because I have no more full-size sheets. Darn it. I didn't know I didn't have enough to do this whole thing. So Heather needs for her birthday a ream of white cardstock. That's not true. And my birthday's over. So, oh gosh, that is a gorgeous background image right there. Wowzers. Look at that sunset gorgeousness. Beautiful. Let's see. I would use them in my custom journal making. Exactly. Exactly. I love that idea. Andrew says much appreciated for the for the crash, boom, bang. Wasn't even planned. Love the sound effects. Thud. Yeah. Oh, wait a second. I missed this. Others call them junk journals, but I don't like the word junk. I hear you, girl. I use the journals to focus on one set of ancestors. And I love that you do that. I love your community that you have, or I think you call it a group over on Facebook where you guys do crafty ancestry stuff. Is so awesome. Spell it junk, junke, and it appears much better. Absolutely, absolutely. And I think junk journals, I think the name came from being made of what you would just throw out, junk. I think that's why they call them junk journals, because you've turned junk into something beautiful, which is exactly what you did. All right, here we go with some teal. And I actually think I need more because I'm really stingy with my color. When I first started, oh my gosh, Sylvia would say to me almost every time, yeah, you don't have enough paint. Yeah, you don't have enough paint. I can still hear her voice saying, yeah, you don't have enough paint. I'm very stingy. Like I'm afraid that if I put too much on, I will mess up everything. All right, really quickly, I think there's something on this brayer that is making my paint behave poorly, but we're going to do it anyway. I don't really care. Here we go. Got these beautiful leaves in every directiones. Yep. Yep, yep. Okay, and back to the deli paper. So now, one thing that's really nice about these fabric leaves is that you can keep them around forever. Whereas you see with this one, eventually, you're not going to be able to use that. It's going to have to go in the trash. But these things I have been printing with for years. They have some history on them. And the more you use them, the more paint they get on them. And over time, their texture may be affected by that paint, which may or may not be good. Who knows? It could be a fabulous addition, actually. So something to keep in mind. We're going to just, whoops, I think I got this one upside down, but that's fine. Just want to make sure I get all that paint off of the plate in those parts. All right. Good enough. We're going to pull this off. Boom, boom, boom. Boom. And then we're going to put this on. And this is kind of neat because you could put this into two different frames and have this continuous piece, like a triptych is three. So what's two? I don't know. Kind of cool though. All right, so here's where I'm giving it a little bit of pressure, just making sure that those impressions get put onto there. And oh, could you imagine if this would have been that PBO shimmery Dyna paints? Oh, Lord have mercy, how amazing that would be. Look at that. I'm so very happy with that. So here we have a teal background with orange print, and here we have an orange background with teal print. Complementary colors, beautiful imagery. I'm loving it. All right, and finally, our yellow and purple. So we did a yellow background with purple, so we're going to do a purple background with yellow. And who knows, it's probably not going to turn out too well because that yellow is not very strong to be on this. But I do have a trick. If you guys are interested in seeing the trick. Did I just do the wrong thing? I most certainly did. I most certainly did. Nobody was here yelling at me. All right, I love that orange so much. We're making another one. Not intentional, just the way it worked. My brayer needs a little bit of grease or something because that's hurting my ears. All right, well, we're just going to put down another one, another pair of cardstocks for another orange background that was totally unintentional and doesn't really matter much. Well, these are two different papers. I didn't know that. That's different. Interesting. Cool. This one is kind of textured a little bit, almost plasticky. That's kind of a weird paper. I don't know what the heck that is. But that makes a beautiful poll no matter what, even if it was a total accident and I didn't mean to do it. Oh, that's gorgeous. Isn't that gorgeous? What a bonus print right there. Yay. All right, now I would like to try purple this time. That's the goal here. Again with the magenta, but this time let's pick up the teal, Heather, because you're trying to make purple, which I realized I messed up when I went to grab the purple brayer and went, wait, no, this won't work. I can't do that. This won't work. Oh my gosh, this color just makes me so happy. Okay, there's some purple. And we have our two pieces, of course, because I'm out of the full sheets of cardstock. So if you're just joining us and you're wondering why I'm doing two, that's the only reason. I'm just out of the full sheets of cardstock. No big deal. All right, what do we got here? So this paint is very washable since you are not wearing gloves. Yeah, it's water-based. I mean, it's just acrylic paint. It's not a big deal. I don't ever wear gloves. If you've watched any of my videos, I don't ever wear gloves. I just don't. It gets in the way for me. And some people are really particular about whether their work surface is clean or their hands are clean. And I'm just not one of those people. After doing this all these years, there was a time when I wore gloves to start because I had people complaining all the time. Look at that purple. That purple is magical. About how toxic the paints are and so on and so forth. And I don't use any toxic paints. I have some that my aunt gave me that are like real cadmiums. I have a couple real cadmiums. I don't ever use them. So, all right, here's my cheat. Instead of using, and I know I've been preaching this whole time about using these three paints, right? But this is transparent. Won't see it very much. This one is not transparent, and it's a thicker viscosity. So this one's going to be a little bit different. So although it's not the same paint, it's still yellow. And we are focusing on the complementary color aspect of what we're doing. So hopefully this one will work for us a little bit better than that high flow acrylic wood for this particular project. That's the goal. Which, if I would have thought about it, I would have done the same thing by using that green instead of the other green. But it doesn't matter. We mixed it. We had a lot of fun. We're doing great. Right, guys? All right, let's put down our leaves, our leaf pattern here and there. Where did all the rest of my leaves go? Lord have mercy, I've buried them. All right, and then we have our deli papers. Let's just use this one. That'll be fun, I think. Maybe it won't, but what do I know? That's going to make for an interesting print in general. See, I this is why I love jelly plating, because it's like this is an art piece, what we're making right now. The next pole is an art piece. You know, every stage of this is a new piece that you can use in one way or another, like in your journals, like Mert said, or in collage, like Lucy has said, or many of us have said. You know, it's just, let's do this one next. So it's got a lot of stuff we can use right here. That's like a primary one, too. It's got the red, the yellow, and the blue right there. It's going to pull this and then get these extra bits I missed up here and up here. So the idea is to just lift off as much of the paint from the plate as you can, but especially around those objects, whatever your objects are. And as you see, you can use anything that has texture. Just so long as you can maneuver that deli paper around it. And we've got our purple background we're just going to go ahead and put on here. And I just flung the other half to the ground, so that was positive. I hate when you can't see me make these kind of mistakes, Andrew. I just feel so bad for you when I do that to you. I'm sorry. All right, so here we go. Final bit. Yeah, it looks like the night sky. Totally agree. All right, here we go. This is it. This is our moment of truth and the end of our complimentary colored jelly plate session, which I'm very excited about. I think it turned out really well. Oh, wow. Look at that. Let's put these side by side so that we can see them in their entirety. Wow, that turned out really well. Very much more than I expected out of that one, because if you remember the red and the green, not so much. But so there's the two versions of that particular complementary color. See, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit so we can get a better view of all of these pages. Move these brayers out of my way, because clearly that's a mess waiting to happen. All right, so we're just going to put these over like so. Okay, so here's version one and two of those particular complementary colors. That's awesome. That's very awesome. Here's versions one and two of orange and blue. Another awesome set. Really pretty colors right there. Another version of our complementary colors. Very cool. We did a great job. We've also got these really neat, here, let me turn this over so you have a white background to see this. Look at how neat that is. Isn't that beautiful? That is beautiful. Here's another one with the three primary colors on there. Look at that. That's pretty. And we got a little bit of mixture with the green in there. Would have been nice to have some, it's not really mixed purple up there. Not really seeing the orange right here, but You get the idea. Those are pretty. And we got a couple of those. This one, oh, just this one, I guess, is all we have left. Not a beautiful print, but it's there. Yeah. And then look at these. Look at how fun these are. This, like I said, years of printing on these guys. This is like been here long time. And even our plant. This is real. These are silk. Turned out pretty good, I think. And you know, you can save these doilies too. And the more you print on them, the more plasticky they become, and they become more like their own templates. So even though this is like a cheap, super cheap, inexpensive printmaking tool, you could throw it away if you really wanted to. If you keep printing on it over and over and over again, like let it dry, but then print, and then let it dry, and then print, eventually it turns into almost a plastic template for you. So that's just another little bonus tip there. I hope you guys have had fun with this. This is our accidental print, and that is gorgeous as well. So I have enjoyed this thoroughly. I thank you very much for, we forgot these ones here. So this was our color wheel explanation, color wheel. These were our color mixing sessions right here. That turned out really well. Our pickup one. Look at all that we have from this today. See, this is what I'm saying. You've got a lot to work with here. So what are you going to do with it all? This is a huge pile. That's a huge pile of stuff right there, you guys. Look at that big pile of stuff. All from today's play. Very good. I'm proud of us. We did good. All right, so that's it. I would love to see what you're going to do with your polls. And if you have been playing along, please use that hashtag, Bridget Koopson Gel Printing Challenge is the hashtag. Use Jelly Arts hashtag to let them also find you. And then you'd be entered to win their weekly giveaways, which I believe tomorrow is another weekly giveaway. So you want to make sure that you're in there. Mert says, I'd scan them. And I don't blame you one bit. That's an awesome idea. She says, I love this. Maybe I will buy a jelly plate. Looks like fun. All right. I can't wait to see what you do with it. They come in all different sizes, Mert. So the one I've been using here today is the 8x10. They have huger ones. They also have teeny, teeny, tiny little ones. Very, very fun. Different shapes too. So anyway, I really appreciate you guys being here. I hope that you've had a good time. Tomorrow's our last day of gel printing. I know there's still days left in the month, but I'm just done. I think today was very comprehensive as well. So hopefully you learned something. And you can refer back to this video until it's gone, because they don't hang on to these here very much so on Twitch. So I might download this one and put it on YouTube, because this was really a good color conversation. So we'll see. Thank you, Andrew. I appreciate it. Thank you, Mert. We'll see you guys later. I'm going to put on the outro video, and then we will see you next time, which is tomorrow. And then we're going to start something new next week. Okay, you guys? So have a very crafty day.